Preparing for Celebrity Jeopardy, I wanted to get some help, so I decided to call on the smartest person I knew to sort of help tutor me. Like, from Tony Randall, to see if he could help. Now, Tony, have you ever been on Celebrity Jeopardy?
Yes, I was.
And how did you do?
I should have won.
Mm-hmm.
It's really a question of the thumb.
The buzzer?
Yes.
Buzzer skills.
They've never asked me back again.
Really?
And they've asked you.
Right. Yeah, but I mean, I'm new meat.
Well, I suppose one must face one's own mortality and the inevitability of a decline in the career and the forgetfulness of the public and indeed the fading memories of those who give us jobs. I'm not bitter.
Oh, you're talking about you. I thought you were talking about me for... Okay, go ahead.
I'm finished.
Oh, okay. My opponents are Brian Dennehy and S. Epatha Merkerson.
Yes. Brian Dennehy is a very literate man.
Yeah, well-read.
He's read E.B. White.
Wow. And you don't... That's not... Is that Charlotte's Web?
Yes.
Mm. Yeah, but I read Charlotte's Web when I was 7 years old.
Then you're way ahead of him.
All right.
I can only tell you, don't be afraid.
Well, you know, I've got some visual aids to help me overcome my fear. Here, I've had these made. I'm sure you noticed them already. But I just have been standing in between them.
Well, it's rather daunting.
Oh, sorry, Danny. Oh, Ms. Merkerson, so sorry. Yes, Alex? This is Jonathan Groff. He's the head writer at Late Night with Conan O'Brien. And also, was it five-time Jeopardy champion?
Yeah, I won five times, and I went to the Tournament of Champions in 1995.
Jonathan.
What is a parsec?
Yes, for 1,000.
What are sort of the basic tips? I mean, you know, what are there... Like, I hear rumors of buzzer tips.
Take that.
Okay.
That one here. You really want to... fast action like that. See that? And actually, you want to kind of hit it a couple times really fast like that. And I assume you've been doing that for the last couple of weeks.
No. I found this article, this interview with Dennehy, where he says he, quote, reads a lot. And that kind of worried me.
Personally, I don't think Dennehy's going to be the problem.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to be S. Epatha Merkerson.
I know.
What do you know about her?
Well, you know, Law and Order, acclaimed stage actor, impassioned and gritty yet approachable style. But the thing that really sticks, it really makes me worry, she was Reba, the mail lady on Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Problem. I don't know what you're going to do.
I took a scene from Law and Order, and I doctored it a little just to help motivate me. Watch this.
I found something. It's a handwritten note in her Palm Pilot. It's the bomb, call me, and it's signed Kelly. There's a phone number and a time, 12:30 last night.
Da, 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 da.
You know, her parents said the little angel went to bed at 10:30.
Da, da, da.
Pretty mean, but...
From the Sony Pictures Studio, this is Jeopardy!
This is pretty much my practice method. Let's go with television history, Alex.
This first host of The Tonight Show emceed Meeting of Minds for PBS in 1977.
Clear one? See, this is right up my alley.
Nope. Too bad.
This bishop's talks on Life is Worth Living competed against Milton Berle.
Clear one? Good guess, but no.
Emily. Before we were taping,
I was getting everything right.
Wrong. Oh, I'm sorry, that's wrong. That is incorrect. Anyone? Player three.
I'm doomed.
Okay, it's pretty late. Got in some good work on the PlayStation, though. Some good practice. I'm feeling good. Car's going to be here to pick me up in like 8 hours, so I'm not going to get a whole lot of sleep. But it's going to be good sleep, because I feel like a winner. You know, I'm going to just stay focused. Okay, well, see you tomorrow.
Sandy, get up this early in the morning?
Big day.
How you doing?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
Good.
I bet you I worked later last night than you did.
What time you work till?
11 o'clock.
All right. You know what? No, it's about the same time.
Is it?
Yeah, yeah. We're shooting this thing.
What's it called, that work?
Well, what were you doing, reciting lines?
Yeah.
Wow.
The salesman, the big one.
So you're fucking Sean Colvin and Michael Boatman?
Harvard Crop.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's going to take us down. But
do you think, is that what you think?
Yeah, I get the sense she's going to take us down.
Really?
She seems to have a wide array of knowledge.
Who has the best buzzer skills of the three of you?
I think Colvin's got the rhythm down. I mean, I think she's got the edge rhythmically and educationally. My only hope is that every category is about me or my family.
Mm. Well, I'm up against S. and Peter Merkerson. Brian Dennehy.
Oh, that one. He's just going to intimidate your physical force.
He's already started. He already insulted my job.
Who won? Who lost? Did anyone get violent? To find out, you'll have to check your local
listings! Nicely done.
Thank you.
You can't say what happened.
I can't say what happened.
Yeah. Okay, well, we'll leave it.
Sometime in mid-November.
Sometime in mid-November.
That's what I was told.
Watch for the epic struggle.
Yes.
Okay.
Just watch every Jeopardy until then. Jeopardy people love this.
Yeah, they're going to love it. All right, well, we're going to take a little break right now. Good work, Andy. When we come back, Jon Stewart going to be joining us. So stick around.